Greetings. Recently, I wanted to study some of the unfulfilled prophecies of the Bible. Isaiah 17:1. The burden of Damascus. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be a ruinous heap. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city. I find that interesting. Damascus has had a long and well-documented history. Damascus was first settled in the second millennium BC. In 2008, Damascus was chosen as the 2008 Arab Capital of Culture. For 4,000 years, Damascus has been an occupied city. Oh, but I don't mean occupied as if it were a foreign army, the way Muslims and Arabs try to claim Israel is occupied territory. Perhaps inhabited is a better word. But Prophet Isaiah said, "Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city." I wouldn't doubt Prophet Isaiah if I were you. I wouldn't doubt God if I were you. At some point, Damascus is going to become a ruinous heap. And I don't think this is talking about the end judgment when God destroys the entire earth. The NIV says Damascus will no longer be a city, but will become a heap of ruins. The New Living Translation says it this way: the city of Damascus will disappear. It will become a heap of ruins. The Bible in Basic English: see, they have made Damascus a town no longer. It has become a waste place. Remember, Damascus has been a habitable city for 4,000 years. If God said it, if the prophets revealed it, it will happen. But I think the timing of this event deserves some analysis. We know that Islam tells a tale of Issa of Islam appearing at Damascus during noon prayers. You can watch my video about Islam claiming Jesus will return. And Jesus said, "When men said he was in the desert, believe it not." I think it is reasonable to align and juxtapose these two positions and assert that Damascus will not be destroyed before the Antichrist is revealed and Issa appears. But what, then, could cause Damascus to become a ruinous heap, a wasteland, that is not to be occupied again? Modern man has an easy-to-grasp answer. We know how this could happen. How, you ask? I decline to state the obvious. But we cannot answer why, when, or by who. But the why, when, and who are more interesting. But I'll be honest, I don't know those exact answers, and I won't pretend I do know the exact answers. But I have a thought for you to consider. The Antichrist will be ruling in Damascus when Issa appears. And we see in 2 Thessalonians 2, verses 3 and 4, "Don't let anyone deceive you in any way, for that day will not come until the rebellion occurs and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the man doomed to destruction. He will oppose and will exalt himself over everything that is called God or is worshipped, so that he sets himself up in God's temple, proclaiming himself to be God." And then, as we see, at some point, the Antichrist will be ruling in Jerusalem, setting himself up in the temple. Will he conquer Israel to get Jerusalem? I looked for a scripture that clearly stated Jerusalem would be conquered by the Antichrist. I couldn't find one. Or perhaps will Jerusalem be given to him by international pressure? Well, what would create such international pressure? Imagine for a moment, Damascus were destroyed, made a ruinous heap. Would the world instantly unite against Israel if it were claimed that Israel had destroyed Damascus? Would the world demand that Israel give Jerusalem to the previous king of Damascus? Is Satan so evil that he would utterly destroy Damascus as a calculated move to accomplish this? You decide. Be cautious holding on to ideas from eschatology that completely missed that Islam is the religion of the Antichrist. Go back to the Word of God and read the scriptures themselves, not other men's claims, not even mine. Read the Word of God for yourself. Allow the Holy Spirit to teach you and show you. And watch the events in the Middle East and watch for the reborn Turkish Ottoman Caliphate. Watch to see what happens to Damascus and the King of Damascus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.